The Spanish government debt is 20 percentage points below the average of Europe in regard to GDP. So we are not in a situation that is in relation with the very wide spreads that the Spanish debt has. So it is a kind of overreaction of the markets, in my view.
The Spanish government this year will issue around 47 billion euros in medium and long-term debt. Do you think it's sustainable given these widening spreads on the market?
If you take into consideration the rate of interest that the government is paying for these bonds, and you take it to you compare it with GDP, we are talking of figures in about 2% of GDP, which is not a very high figure. So it's, in my way, sustainable, these rates of interest for the Spanish debt.
Now let's talk about Santander, about your bank. Do you think that the market is too tough with Santander, even taking into account the recent profit warning?
We've been affected by the fact of being a Spanish bank, though in Spain we get less than 20% of our net income. We get in excess of 20% in Brazil, 17% in the UK, to give you an example of how well diversified we are as a bank. But inevitably, the perception of the markets put us very close to Spain. So our share price is being affected by the fact of being in Spain. So we hope that the market will understand that this diversification is a very, very positive asset for Santander. And I'm very optimistic that looking forward, looking in the future, these elements are going to be considered by the markets.
You have a limited exposure to the Spanish economy. We got the message. What's the roadmap this year for Santander?
Santander, as I said earlier, is a very well diversified bank. We have a very important integration operations now in Brazil, in the UK, with the acquisitions of the branches of the Royal Bank of Scotland, integration in Germany. So we hope that this process of integration will create for us synergies and potential growth for the future. So I'm very positive about the future of Santander, given this diversified international structure and the effort of consolidation in some markets that will create for us very positive synergies in terms of earnings and in terms of cost reduction.
In other stories, Airbus has won the largest order in commercial aviation history. The European plane maker will sell 180 planes